Hey everyone, welcome back to our channel Go Dynamic IT. If you are searching for a reliable way to access your computer remotely, remotely means anywhere in the world using internet and without spending any money, then this video is perfect for you. Today I will show you how to set up a Google Chrome remote desktop to access your computer. We'll go through the configuration on Windows 10, Windows 11 and Server 2022. Then we'll test how to remote access from your mobile phone and different system. So without any further delay, let's dive into the video. Okay, so first let's go to our Windows 11 machine. So you can see this is my Windows 11 machine, and we'll go to our Google Chrome in fact. And inside the Google Chrome, we have to type remote desktop Google Chrome. So you can see this first link will come. So this is where it will ask you to set up your remote, right? And you should be logged into your Google account. You can see I have logged into my Google account, and this account should be logged into the system where you are configuring the remote access, and this should be on your system from where you are going to access. The both the system should have this email account, right? So this is the requirement. Now he says that set up the remote access. Okay, I want to set up the remote access. So he says that set up your computer remotely access from another device. Okay, you have to download the software. We'll come back to that. First, let's explore these three options. And he says that remote support. Okay, so with the help of this software, you can share your screen. Yes, you can share your screen with somebody else who is controlling your computer, and then you can connect to the another computer also. Yes, you, with the help of this remote access code, you can log into any computer. And then the second option is via SSH. So SSH is not, we are not going to cover this SSH option here. We'll cover these two options, remote access and remote support. Okay, so first thing first, let's go download, let's go ahead and download the remote access software. This is a very small software which will download on our system. So let's go ahead and add it, download it. Okay, so we have to add it to the Chrome. Okay, let's add it as an extension. Okay, it says that Google Remote Desktop has been added to the Chrome. Perfect. So anything else we have to do? No, that's it. And then once extension is added, you have to click once again, and then where there is small software which you need to install it. So you can click on accept and install, and you can see this is the small software. Let's open that. This is just a 20 MB file which you need to run it on your system. You can see they say that please wait your Windows configuration. Please wait while your system is configured. Okay, click on the yes and install this application. Done. So you can see it says that choose your name. So I'll give this name as like Windows 11 PC and click on the next, and it says choose your PIN. PIN means whenever you are trying to log into the system, it will ask you the PIN. So my PIN will be, so I said minimum 6 digit. Okay, and re-enter the PIN. Okay, so we have set up the PIN, and then click on the start. So it's starting the application in the background, starting, and now we can see this Windows 11 PC is online. Okay, perfect. Now this is about, this is for the Windows 11. Now let's go to our Windows 10 PC. Okay, so as you can see here, this is my Windows 10 PC. Let's go to our browser and just type this remote desktop Chrome. And once you type that, we have to go to, again, go back to our extension, and you can see access my computer. Okay, we have to go to this remote desktop.google.com and access my computer. And once you go there, it will show, it's showing a different account, but don't worry, I'll change that account from here. I'll use this account test, and now we can see here I have logged in here, and then this is showing me this Windows 11 PC for me. I'm not going to log in from Windows 11 PC here. I'm going to set up this also as a remote, assuming that I want to access this system remotely also. This is the Windows 10. So again, same thing, we have to go to this extension and download this extension in our system. First we have to add it to the Chrome, so it will going to add the extension, and you can see the extension has been downloaded, sorry, extension has been added to your Chrome. And now again, click again so that it will download the small tiny software, and then we have to accept and install it. So software, install it, click on the yes on the program. Okay, fine. Actually I have clicked time, so it says that there is another program installing. That's fine, go ahead and install it. Okay, now it's asking about the choose your name. So what I will do is we'll give this Windows 10 PC, click on the next, and again it's asking about the choose the PIN. So let's choose our PIN. Okay, after choosing the PIN, click on the start. No, I don't want to save it. Services is being started in the background, just wait for that. Yes, and now we can see this Windows 10 PC is starting. Perfect. So we have a Windows 11 and we have a Windows 10 under this account. Now, as I said that, few people want to access their server also remotely, right? Because server is a very important component. Maybe security is a different thing. We can debate on that, but that's not a question here. This is about just to access your server. So let's go to our Windows server system. We will test it how this is going to work, right? This is just the education. Okay, as you can see here, this is Windows Server 2022. You can see Server 2022, a standard edition. This is the evaluation. Close this one and go to our browser. Inside the browser, we have to type this remote desktop Chrome. Log into the first link, and then we can see we have logged into this account. So it's showing me the two Windows 10 and Windows 11 PC. I want to enable this remote access on this computer also. The same thing, we have to go, you can blue button, click on that, and it is going to add the extension to your browser. Add this extension, add extension. We'll see how it's going to work on the server as well. That's our intention. So now it says that successfully added this extension to Google Chrome. Now it's time to install this tiny software on this machine. As you can see, this is downloading. Let's see if that is supported or not. Okay. So you can see this is downloaded, and double click on it. Okay, so it says that choose your name. So we can see this Windows 2022 server SRV. Make it that's caps. Good. And click on the next, and it says that choose your PIN. So PIN here. Okay. So done that. So okay, so you can see here this says that it's starting and it's showing me the Windows 10, Windows 11 and your Wins 2022 server. So we have three accounts here. So isn't it useful tool for any of the person who is in a support job or tech job or anything which you like, your team or something, right? If you have a team who works under, and if you support your team related to a specific software, Tally or anything which you name, right? So you can see this beautiful tool for you. So you can go ahead and set up this remote access on your Windows 10, Windows 11 and Server 2022. So now let me tell you one thing. So this is very helpful for you, if especially you have elderly parents or relatives. You can go ahead and help them if they need help from you, right? So one thing which is common here, so these all are into same internet. So let me show it to you, speed test. So this is just for demonstration purpose. This PC can be in the different geographical location. Means you can say this one in the US, one in the UK, and one could be another in UAE. But as of now, for just for demonstration purpose, you can see this is on my GeoFiber. Go to Windows 10 machine and do the speed test. This is all machine, this is all are connected to the same. You can see this is on the Geo and the IP address is 49, and let's go to our third and check the speed test. You can see this is all are having the same IP address. So this is on just for demonstration purpose. These are all in the same network, but in your case it could be the three different geographical location. Now so assume that I'm going to access this all of this PC from my different location. Let's say I'm in India. I want to access these computers, right? These are all geographically separate. So what we will do is let's jump into the our other system. Let's say client. Okay, so I'm on my client system. Let's say I'm in from India and I'm trying to access all those three PCs. Those are different locations. So let's go to our browser and let me test this internet and show it to you that this is the different internet. So let me run through this one, and you can see here, you can see this is the IP address is starting from 152.58.237. This is also a Geo because this is the mobile internet, Geo mobile internet, and that the one which you saw, that's my fiber. Okay, so let's do one thing. Let's go to again go to our browser. As of now you can see here I'm using the Edge here, Microsoft Edge here. I do not have a Google Chrome, so let's see if that works on the Microsoft Edge as well or not, right? So type the Chrome in your Edge, type the Chrome desktop, and inside the Chrome desktop we have to go to this link, remotedesktop.google.com. Go to this link and just click on this access my computer and see that if that is going to work on the Microsoft Edge or not. Oh, perfect. So you can see here, since I have logged into my account, I can see all this PC here, all are online, right? So which one you want to access, tell me, just put me in the comment which one you want to see first, which one we should access first. I just want people to put in the comment, and then based on that I will take that. Pausing the video for a second and then we'll start. Okay, let's go with the Windows 11 first. So Windows 11 is the winner. Let's click on the Windows 11. It says that you can see connecting, and okay, oh, it's asking about the PIN. So let's enter our PIN. You have an option to remember my PIN here also, but that's fine. Just click on the okay. and you can see this is connecting, and I should have this. You can see I can access my Windows 11 PC inside the Microsoft Edge. This is the power of this Google Remote Desktop. And you can see this IP address which we run as a test here, and let me show it to you. This is the Windows 11 PC. You can see when I click on here, this is our Windows 11 PC, right? And let me show you the configuration. This can see Windows 11 PC online, this device, right? So we can we disconnect it and try to connect it to the other computer? Yes, we can do that. So where is that option to disconnect it? Okay, right click on it, and it says I just click on this back button, and I just came out. Again, we have an option to remote desktop, and let's log into this Windows server here second time, and it says that you can see this is connecting, and let's see if that connects to Windows server or not. Okay, it says asking for the password, so it's asking about the pin, so let's add our pin here. Done. Oh, you can see this is asking about that if you want to copy this images or text through this remote desktop or not. Yes, I want to do that. Click on allow, and now he say that you want to know the location, which I don't want to share it, please, sorry Google. And I can see here this is our server 2022, right? So we are able to access our server as well. Okay, perfect. So I just wanted to do one thing. I just wanted to test one thing here. Let's go back to one of our computer there. Okay, and which computer we are in? We are in Windows 11. So let's go to the remote support, and the remote support, it says I want to share my screen. Okay, generate the code. So it's generating the code to share your screen. So you know what it does it when you have this code enable, it does what it does it. Let's try to read that and understand. To let someone else access this computer, click below to generate one-time access code and then share this code with the person who want to allow access. They will be able to see your screen and control your keyboard and mouse. Perfect. So you know you have many application in the market which you need to pay for that, but Google is giving you this option free of cost, right? So you have to, what you have to do is you have to just copy this code from here. And once you copy this code, you have to go to the different machine. So let's say I'm in on this machine, and you have to go to remote access, and you can see connect to computer, just copy and paste the code here. And you can ask this over the phone also, right? You can get this code over the phone and connect. Let's see where it's connecting. You can see support session, and this is the number. It's going to connect it. Okay, you know, once somebody requests that, on your screen, you get this option that would you like allow this email ID to control your computer? You have to click on the share. If you do not click on the share, that option won't, that the other person don't get this option to log in here. So let me show you what error you got it. This got timeout. Again, we have to go and request for that. You can see I'm on this one. Let's click on the connect. And it says that support is connecting. So it will keep on connecting until unless you are requesting to the one, he has to allow it. You have to click on the share. So let's go back to our system there. Now, I think that we have to generate the code, because that code get expired in, there are some certain time, I think 4 minutes, 5 minutes. So then within a 5 minute, this code will expire if you not use that, right? So let's copy this code again, and go back to our system, and let's access this code. Click on the code and connect. When you click on connecting, it says that connecting. Now we have to go to the requested PC, and we have to share that. Okay, so I'm on requested PC. You can see here this is Windows 11, and we have to click on the share it, and you can see your desktop is being shared with this email ID. You can stop sharing. So this is from here you can stop sharing and see what other computer, like the requester, see on my screen. Okay, you say that you want to allow this images and text to be copied. Yes, allow it. And now you can see this is the Windows 11 PC. Let me click here, and I will be able to access everything on it. Let's go open this drive. You can go to download documents, right? This PC, everything can access, right? So this is a perfect for the remote access, or this is perfect for your, to help your relatives and colleagues. Now, as I promised, I'll show you how to do that from the mobile phone also. Okay, so let's go and grab our mobile phone. Okay, so I'm on my mobile phone now, and let's go ahead and connect to the different internet here. Okay, so you can see here I'm connected to my mobile phone, and this mobile mobile phone, I have a different internet. So let me show you that then test. And let's go to the speed test here. Should be the different one. Continue with the web. You can see this is the Vodafone India, right? So now let's close this one. Go to our Play Store and type here Chrome Remote Desktop. And you can see this is the second line, the second option here, Chrome Remote Desktop. Click on install. And it's going to install. This is just a 0.96 MB, says that. Open and log to the account. It says that let's change my account here because I have two account added here. So I can see here on my mobile phone, at the moment I change my account, you can see on my mobile phone I have a three option here. You can see Windows PC, Windows 10, Windows 11 and Windows Server 2022. So which one should I click first? Please put me in the comment box. Which one should I click on first? Okay, so this time we'll click on this server. So once you request it, it will ask for the PIN, right? This is just a simple request. So let's add our PIN here, connect, and you can see I have a Windows. I can control my Windows machine from the mobile phone here. So I think we have covered almost everything for today's agenda here, right? So that's it for today's video. If you have any questions, query, or any feedback related to this video, please do let me in the comment box. Thank you very much for watching the video. See you in the next one.